With the help of a funny story today, we will learn addition and subtraction of numbers. Appu once asked Bunny to rear his sheep. Appu had a total of 568 sheep. A week later, when Bunny returned in the evening with the sheep, Appu found that 127 sheep were missing. When Appu asked Bunny about those 127 missing sheep, Bunny told him that a wolf came daily to the mountain area where he took the sheep to graze, and the wolf ate 127 sheep in a week. Appu is wondering how many sheep he is now left with. Can you help Appu find how many sheep are left with him? To know the number of sheep left with Appu, we will subtract 127 sheep from 568 sheep. We will write 568 and 127 this way using 100, 10 and 1 digit places like this in the place value chart. What should we do now? On subtracting the digits 8 and 7 in the ones place, we get 1. What do we do next? Absolutely correct. From 6 tens, subtract 2 tens and we get 4 tens. And finally, when we subtract 100 from 500, what do we get? 400. As we had calculated, Appu now has 441 sheep left with him. Appu gave Bunny his 441 sheep to graze again. Bunny returned after a week with Appu's sheep. This time again, Appu felt the number of sheep were less. When Appu counted, he found that this time there were 135 sheep less. Upon asking Bunny the reason, he again gave the same story of the wolf. Appu was sad and now he was wondering how many sheep he is left with. Can you again help Appu calculate? To find out the total number of sheep lost, we will add the number of sheep went missing the first time to the number of sheep missing the second time, that is 135 and 127. What do we have to do first? Yes, by adding 7 ones to 5 ones, we get 12 ones. How will we write 12 ones? That's correct. Using the carryover method, 10 tokens of 1 can be written as 1 token of 10, as 1 in the tens place. And now how many tokens are left with us? 2 tokens of 1. Now how many tens do we have? 6 tens. Now on adding all the hundreds, what do we get? 200s. Appu lost a total of 262 sheep. This time, Appu asked Bunny to come a week later to take the sheep. That week, Appu went to the market. There he saw one of his sheep with Gagu. Only Appu had one and only black sheep in the entire village. So, he quickly recognized it. Upon asking Gagu, Appu got to know that he had bought the sheep from Bunny. Now Appu came to know that his sheep were not eaten by any wolf. Rather, Bunny was selling his sheep in the market for a good price. Next week, when Bunny came to take the sheep, Appu hid amongst the sheep. Appu caught him red-handed as soon as Bunny came to the market to sell the sheep. Bunny apologized to Appu and returned all the money he got by selling his sheep. Children, today in this lesson, we learned an easy method of adding and subtracting of numbers. We will see few more interesting examples in the next lesson. Method of addition and subtraction of numbers. In this lesson, we will see some interesting examples of the same. All the traders of the village used to visit the city often to sell their goods. On the way to the city, the sun was very harsh and there was only one tree on the entire route. All the traders would rest in the shade of this tree and then walk towards the city. One day, Appu was going to the city with 250 boxes of sweets from his shop. Like all the traders, he slept in the shade of the tree to take some rest. When Appu woke up, he saw that he now had only 31 boxes of sweets. When he looked up, he saw that there were lots of monkeys on the tree eating sweets from his boxes. Earlier, Appu had 250 boxes of sweets and now he has only 31 boxes of sweets. Can you tell how many boxes of Appu's sweets were taken by the monkeys? How do we find out the number of boxes the monkeys had taken? We need to subtract the number of boxes Appu was carrying with him from the number of boxes left with Appu. We will write 250 and 31 using 100, 50. 10 and 1 digit places in the place value chart. Is this correct, children? We have 0 ones. Can we subtract 1 from 0? No. What do we have to do now? Absolutely right. To find a solution to this, we will use the borrowing method we learned in the previous lesson. We will borrow 1 tens out of 5 tens. Now we have 10 ones and 4 tens. If we subtract 1 ones from 10 ones, how many remains? 9 ones. If we subtract 3 tens from 4 tens, how many tens remain? 1 ten. And finally, subtract 0 hundred from 200. Then what do we get? 200. The monkeys took Appu's 219 sweet boxes. Babban was very clever. He had heard from the villagers about the mischief of the monkeys and had thought of a plan. The next day, Babban took a few hats and set out towards the city. He deliberately slept under the same tree. When he woke up, he realized some of his hats were missing.
He looked up to see the monkeys were wearing his 115 hats.
And he had 208 hats left with him. Can you tell how many hats did Babban have with him earlier? Well done, children. You have solved it correctly. Here, we have used the method of addition. Babban previously had a total of 323 hats with him. Babban now put his plan into action. He knew that the monkeys would surely imitate whatever he does. So he took off his hat and threw it on the ground. Babban's plan worked. Whatever he thought, it happened. Seeing Babban throwing his hat on the ground, the monkeys also threw their hats on the ground. Babban immediately collected all the hats and proceeded towards the city. Thus, Babban taught the monkeys a good lesson. From that day, the monkeys never bothered anyone. Children, in this lesson, we have seen some more interesting examples of addition and subtraction of numbers. In the next lesson, we will learn some interesting facts about it. Children, in the last lesson, we have seen some interesting examples of addition and subtraction of numbers. In this lesson, we will cover some common mistakes related to this. In the village, anyone who has any doubt in mathematics goes straight to uncle. Today, Golu Panda also reached out to uncle with a doubt. Golu Panda is telling uncle that today morning, Babban came to his dairy to get milk. He gave Golu rupees 192 and Golu was to take rupees 65 from him. Golu could not find out how much money he would have to return to Babban. Golu had written the question like this.
Golu dear, you have written this question wrong. While subtracting numbers, we always have to subtract the smaller number from the larger number. To show this, we write the larger number above the smaller number. Here, the larger number is 192 and the smaller number is 65. So, we will write your question this way. Now, we can solve this very easily using the method of subtraction. Uncle explained to Golu. Children, can you solve this? Well done, children. You have solved it correctly. Babban has to return an amount of rupees 127. Golu was very happy. Children, can you tell which of these additions is correct? Yes, you got it right. This addition is correct. But why is this wrong? Absolutely right. Here, while writing a two-digit number 32, we have written the digits in the wrong place. In which place should we write 3 of 32? Tens. And 2? Exactly. In the ones place. Children, remember, while writing any number, you must take extra care to write its digits in the correct place. Golu understood his mistakes and is happy to finally solve it. He promised Uncle not to repeat those mistakes while adding and subtracting numbers. Children, we hope that you too will not make these mistakes. In this lesson, we saw a few common mistakes related to addition and subtraction of numbers.